this older lady that is sitting in a flower garden. So she's actually sitting on her hiney, and there is flowers all around her. And she's saying that she has the male with her. So I'm just trying to wait for the image to form. But she's already kind of fading and she's coming back to me. But I am picking up like a E-A-R around that. So this could be like Arlene, Arlena, Arlen around that. But she's saying that she has the male with her. That's just an image that I was picking up real quick. But I'm waiting for her to come back to me. So I'm going to place that right there. Real quick, there is this male trying to form. The connection is trying to form. He's there. It's the connection. He is holding a Bible. He is outside. There is like this wood looking porch around him. He looks to be probably around like 80s to 90s. He's saying that his love greeted him. I am picking up like a wheel or around that. So this could be William, wheel around that. But he's saying that his love greeted him. This could be a third party, but it's okay. I'm going to continue this message real quick. He says that he wanted to be with his love again, and they're together. So I feel that his love greeted him. He's turning to the left of him. There is a female trying to come through. She's sitting in a chair and she's talking about this quilt. It's like a quilt or some type of blanket. It's something, but it's over her lap. She looks around 70s to 80s, and she's talking about this certain button. So I don't know if a button fell off of this piece of thing that she made or something with a quilt, but she is talking about a certain button. Something Anna, something Anna. So I feel a D, 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 and it's something Anna. Diana, that a Lee is here. Lee is here. She's done faded. So again, this could be a third party. So I feel that there is an Anna. It could be like a Diana, something. Diana around that. She is talking about a button. I'm seeing white puffy clouds right now. See big white puffy clouds right now. There is this boy that is on top of these clouds. He is kind of like jumping from cloud to cloud, cloud to cloud. And then he sits on the edge of the cloud with his feet hanging, dangling from the clouds, and he looks down. So this tells me that this little boy is in heaven, and he's watching over his family, because when he looks down, he can see the earth. So it tells me that he is in heaven, that he has passed, and that he is drawing in the clouds. He lays back and puts his hands above his head, and he's looking up. I'm trying to wait for the connection to form. This little boy looks to be around 9 to 13, around that. He takes his finger and he draws into the cloud like a big C or around that. But he makes a goofy face and he goes, I send stuff all the time. Like he keeps making like this goofy face and he's like, I send stuff all the time. So that tells me that he does send signs all the time. But I feel that people look over him and he's like, so he does another sign and then they look over him and he's like, I'm sending stuff all the time. I feel that someone actually asked like, please give me a sign, please. And he's like, I'm sending stuff all the time. He wants you to look to the clouds, though, so I feel that he does do signs in the clouds. And then again, you'll know, too. Like, you'll get that feeling, wow, that was him. Because you'll get the goosebumps, you'll get the chills, you'll absolutely know. It's not just When I say signs and they send signs, it's not just like regular. You'll absolutely know when they send a sign because you'll feel it and you'll absolutely know it was from them. The image is changing. He's taking me to a field. He's going down a hill. I see giant, really big, dark orange pumpkins right now. And he's walking the field with pumpkins right now. So I feel that this is a sign that he's trying to show me. I'm waiting to see what he's trying to show me. He talks about someone going somewhere. I don't know if it's to this field with pumpkins or he sends pumpkins. So maybe he's trying to make a big deal for the month of October. Like he's trying to show love, or maybe it was something special with pumpkins, but I feel that he's trying to show something or mention something for the month of October with this boy. He talks about how they go and they like to think by themselves. They don't really speak how they feel, and he's there with them when they do that, when they miss him. He doesn't want any blame. He keeps talking about no blame. So I don't know if someone's having a really hard time and blaming themselves, but he doesn't want that. He doesn't want any regrets. I don't know if someone found him or was with him, but he's bringing that up and he doesn't like the fact that they had to see him that way. But he snaps his finger, which tells me that I feel that this was very quick and that he didn't really feel this. This is what I feel. I don't feel that this was more of a sickness or something like that. I feel that maybe this was some type of like freak accident, like it was a very sudden thing. This is nothing that wasn't planned or anything like that. I feel that this was a very like, because he snaps his finger. Feel a little chest heavy with this person. Maybe they had struggle breathing, but just know that they're able to breathe now. I'm going to call the other one C, if that's okay. He points and says, he's here. I am getting an O initial or around that. I feel something around 80s to 90s with this person. This could be a third party connection trying to come in. Feel that the younger, the C, passed before the O, and so C helped greet this person. He's talking about a piece of his hair. I'm sorry, C is. He's talking about a piece of his hair, so I don't know if someone has his hair or a piece of his hair, but he is bringing that up. He's in a field now. There is butterflies, and it looks to me, I'm not 100% sure, but it looks more like a dragonfly, and it's flying around him, and he's in a field with the C is. There is an O initial there, so this is a male that's with him as well, and they're together. I feel the snapping of the fingers with this boy, which tells me that this happened pretty quickly. And he doesn't want the regrets. He wants people to live life in his memory and love life and, you know, look at the rainbows, look at the sunsets and enjoy life and not feel sad to move on because he knows how much he's loved. He is starting to fade. I feel this little boy is an important message. Now, this could be a third-party message, but he's coming through so strongly. So, if you know of a little boy that's passed, Here is his scribbles. If you find out who it is, send me a message. But I think this is a very important message for his family to know that they need to move on, pretty much. Live life. This male looks maybe, I don't know, around 50s to 60s. I am picking up a B initial with this guy. I don't know if he was called this. I don't know if he had a different name, but he's showing me a B right now, more of like a B E-E-E-L or B-I-L-L-L around that, but he's between 50s to 60s around that. He is taking me somewhere, so he's telling me to come on. I'm trying to see what he's showing me. He is pointing. He is with another male. This is very, very important. The image is starting to fade for just a minute, so stay with me for just a minute. So I see two males right now, but I do see a female. There's flowers all around her. She closes her eyes, and I can see her energy radiating from her to this other male. And she's okay. She's a very strong soul, but I feel that she's trying to give her energy to this other guy so he can come through because it's important. This other guy that's with B, I'm gonna call him B if that's okay. He's around 20s to 30s around that. He sits down into an Indian style. He takes his glasses off, dusts them off, puts them back on his face and smiles, and then he goes, nah, and he takes his glasses off. So I don't know if he had trouble seeing or had something with his vision or something, but just know that he is able to see better now. And that's just a sign, I think, that he was trying to show me something with his glasses, or somebody kilt his glasses or something with his glasses. Okay. Does this make sense? Okay. My head hurts a little bit with him. I don't know if he had headaches or something like that, but just know that his head doesn't hurt anymore. He is okay. And he clears his throat and he goes, hello. So I am just waiting for the connection. He's showing me the stars. I'm trying to envision of how I see him. There's big bright stars all around him. He also kind of snaps his finger, okay? So it tells me that something happened very quickly, no suffering with him. I feel that he looks up to the stars and there's a sky, so I feel something at darkness. I'm waiting to see what he will show me. He is saying something about his head, but he needs everyone to know that he is okay. He's tapping his feet, and he's kind of nodding his head. So I don't know if he enjoyed music or something along that, but he's doing that right now. There is another male trying to step forward real quick. He looks to the left of him. There's this guy and he's waving. So I'm just waiting for the connection. Hey, Chuck. Hey, Chuck. Hey, Chuck. I'm Chad. I'm Chad. I feel that this is a younger guy. I'm not really sure. He just wants his family to know. If you talk to him, hello, tell him I'm okay. I don't know who this fella is, but he looks young, probably around like his 30s or around that. But he's mentioning like a Chuck, Chucky, Chuck around that. And he goes, Chad. So it's going to be something like that. So I feel that there could be a chat that's passed, and this could be a third party message. And if you find out who this is, you're going to definitely have to let me know. But he just says hello. So I'm just waiting for the connection. There is questions. I'm sorry. The guy with the glasses. He keeps talking about his glasses and he's laughing, so I don't know what that is. But he talks about that there was questions. He says something that I'm just going to tell you how I see it. So I'm seeing like this road and something runs out in front of him. Okay. So I don't know exactly what that is, but then he had to take like a left. So I don't know what that is, but just know that he is okay. And I have a snapping of the finger and I feel that this happened very quickly. Okay. He's very sorry. But just know that that's, when they go to heaven, they don't have any guilt. They don't have any, you know, no sadness or anything like that. He's happy. He's healed. But that's what he's showing me right now. So I feel that this is something with the stars around him. So I feel something with nighttime. Maybe he enjoyed looking out at the stars, or if someone maybe goes out there and talks to him during that at nighttime with the stars. But, or this could have happened at nighttime around the stars. But this is what he's showing me. He's like, all I could see was bright lights. So I don't know if someone accidentally like blinded him or something and he couldn't see or something along that line. But there's two things that he talks about. And he says that there's something that ran out in front of him. It was like a something that ran across. And then the lights blinded him and couldn't see. So I don't know what that is. So I don't know if someone had some questions of like what happened or wonder. But he needs those answered. And he's trying to answer them for you. The bee is holding a yellow flower, so I don't know if he enjoyed a yellow flower, but there's something with this special yellow flower, and he is smiling. Now, he is with the female, and he needs everyone to know he's okay. I don't know if he had the trouble breathing or the struggling of the breathing, but just know he's able to breathe, because he shows me this yellow flower, and he breathes. Okay?
Yeah, I remember that he was like, he had green on, he loved flowers, he always had beautiful flowers.
Regarding the hair
and the glasses, he was always, we always teach him because he was always losing his glasses.
Uh-huh.
And like, we would buy him glasses, all of us, and he would lose them.
So he doesn't need, he don't need his glasses no more.
But the one with the bright light, with the fiance had a wreck, and we never really knew what happened.
Well, there's two things that he's talking about. There was something that ran, so I don't know if it was a place to where animals could like run across. But there was something that ran because you're showing me something like quick come by him, and then all he could see was lights. So I don't know exactly what that means, but he was wanting his family to know that that's the last thing that he's, yeah. But he is okay, and he needs you to know that. I feel that the female is there. There's flowers around her, okay? There's all kind of flowers around her. She's happy. And she is mentioning something with Christmas. So I don't know if that was like her favorite. I'm not really sure if someone does a memory of with Christmas or something with Christmas with her. But just know that she's there and she's kind of taking care of them. The best way I can describe this with her is she's okay, but she's still taking care of the family, okay? But she needed, I feel like it was more important for him to come through. Like, y'all needed to hear from him. So she radiated her energy from her because she's such a strong soul to give it to him for him to step forward, if that makes any sense. Now, there is another male trying to step forward. Now, this could be a third-party message. I'm not really sure. He's talking about water. He's near the water. Now, he's talking about, well, you know, and that's how he kind of talked. Sorry, I'm trying to tell you exactly how I seem. He's talking about, like, these ledges that kind of go in a little bit, and there's this water. I see an O, and then I see a D, and then I see, like, an E. So, this is something like an O-D, O-Dis, O-D around that, or O-D around that. Now, this could be a third-party message, so if you find out who this belongs to, you'll definitely have to let me know. He's saying something. He says, tail, tail, tail. He's starting to fade, so I'm trying to get him back. I'm Sorry, I'm still saying the yellow flower. I'm trying to get it. He says, hold on. Tell a Jane, Jamie, James. So this is going to be around that. He's mentioning a Jane, Jamie's, James. Tell Jane, Jamie's, James. Beth's here. Beth's here. So this could be something like a Elizabeth, something Beth, and a Beth, something. But it's going to have something with a Beth in it. She looks between probably around 80s to 90s. Now she's holding a doll, so I don't know if there's something with the doll or around that. And she shows me a number two, and she needs everyone to know that her love greeted her. So it's a very sweet image of how I see her. So just remember that the third party message that he just gave. And if you find out who she and he belongs to, you'll definitely have to let me know. The sweet lady, something Beth, and she does hold a doll and something with a number two. Sorry, y'all. There's this mail. I have to say it real quick. He's been bugging me. He was bugging me since this last connection. He's asking if there is glue on this table. Like, he's here. And so sometimes I can see images in my mind, and sometimes they're full-blown, like, actual, like, spirits here. His energy comes and goes, a very strong soul, but I can see him to the left of me, and he is knocking on this table. So he's wanting to know if it's made out of wood, which it's not, and does it have Elmer's glue on it. So I don't know if he's obsessed with Elmer's glue or something. I don't know, but he's talking about something with Elmer's glue, and this could be also a sign. This could be maybe he played a joke with Elmer's glue. This could be part of a nickname, Elmer's glue, or something with Elmer. I'm not really sure. But he's mentioning something about glue. So I am just waiting for the full connection. But his energy is coming and going, but he is here at this moment. This male does salute at me. I'm going to say he's probably around 70s to 80s, around that age. So I'm going to call him Elmer Glue, if that's okay with you. You may actually feel him just a little bit. You'll feel the coldness. He's just walking around. He's okay. His energy is here, but it's coming and going. So I feel that there is some type of connection. So, like, again, this could be, you'll know when you get home, go, oh, yeah, that was for me, and Elmer Glue, you know, but he is here. So I feel that he is connected to one of you. He says number three. He says, I had to wait number three to see her. So I don't know if he had to wait 3 years to see someone or something with the number three or around that with number three. But he is mentioning something about three. He says that he had to wait number three to see her. So I feel like this could be possibly a personal message or something, or maybe someone passed away 3 years after. I'm not really, really sure, but he is mentioning number three. The image is starting to change, and I see flowers in a field, a lot of flowers actually. He's still knocking. I don't think there's glue. This lady looks around 80s, maybe a little older. There's flowers everywhere. Oh, the man is back. The Elmer Glue, he still is saying that he had to wait number three to see her. I can hear hums of joy to the world over and over and over.
My dad's name is Elmer.
Elmer.
And my mother passed away 3 years later.
3 years later. Okay. So he had to wait 3 years to see her. So that makes complete sense. Okay. Perfect. Thank you for validating. He's talking about a table still, so I don't know if he made things and he's talking about it, like it's like a table or something like that. And he says that some of his work's passed down, so I don't know if some of the people have his work or something like that, then he's just bringing that up. And he's very proud of that, and he's very proud. He's like, I can fix anything. He can build anything. And so he's just saying that, like, he'll be the type to come and fix anything, if that makes sense. Especially, like, he's wanting to know if this is, like, wood and it's plastic. So I don't really know what that means, but...
He built outdoor furniture.
Oh, perfect.
Picnic tables and swings and such.
Okay. Well, he's just talking about some of his work as being passed down, and he's very proud of that. So I don't know if someone has some of his work, and he's just bringing that up. Smell a lot of flowers with this female, so I feel that she leaves her scent behind, and I hear joy to the world over and over and over. So this could be part of a name, a nickname around that name, and maybe she liked to hum and stuff, but I can smell like a sweet scent with her. So I don't know if she enjoyed flowers or something sweet scent with her, but I can smell that with her. Now there is an L trying to come through, so I'm just waiting for this connection. I'm going to say probably older, like past 70s with this person. This is a male because he is saluting at me, so I'm just waiting for the connection. I see LL, LL, salute, LL, LL, salutes. He is pointing at me right now. He's talking about my name. I feel that my name is, you know, Angel Lee, but also my real name, that's my work name, it's got, you know, Sarah Lee, and he's saying something about Lee, L-E-I-G-H, and it's spelled that way. So I don't know if this could be a third party message or half of a name, part of a name, you know, but that's connected to that he is talking about something Lee, something Lee, something Lee. So this could be part of his name around that name, but I do pick up an LL, LL with this male. He also shows me a number 5, which shows me that this could be a date, years past, sibling, something with the number 5. He's in the field too with a lot of flowers. He is leaning over and he picks up a flower and he says number 9. I feel that he's trying to make a big deal for something with the number 9. Maybe this is the month of September for someone that he's trying to send a flower to, but just know that he's doing that. He says Tars here, Tar, so there's a T-A-R as well that's there as well. I feel that this is a female, but I do pick up a T-A-R, T-A-R is there as well. That's all I'm hearing from him. T-A-R says that she comes in dreams. So she does come in dreams. There is another male trying to come through. He goes, I'm Dan. This could be Dan, Danny, Daniel, around that. He says, I'm just stopping by. So I'm just waiting to see what he's going to show me. Feel that this is a Dan. Dan, he keeps waving. He says next month will make a year for him. So I feel that maybe by like next month, it'll be a year that maybe he's passed or something along that line. Okay, so this is what he's telling me. This could also be a third party message that's trying to come in. He wants his love to know that there's a best there. So I feel that he's mentioning something about his love, but he needs his family to know that there is a B-E-S-S there as well. I still hear a female. She's also there, and I feel the sweet scent with her and a lot of flowers, and I hear joy to the world. So I don't know if there's a joy or something around that joy that's there as well. In the background, there is a guy trying to come forward. He's pretty young.
And my mother's name is Joyce Joanne.
Joyce Joanne. There's this male in the background. He's not wanting to come forward. I'm gonna say he's probably around like 18 to 25. So he's gonna be under 30, but older than 18. Okay, so he's around that age. Looks pretty young. He is showing me a T initial, and he snaps his finger and says very quickly. So he needs everyone to know. Elmer glue moves things around the house. So if you see that things have been moved and stuff like that or knocked over, you're like, what was that noise? You know, stuff like that is him. He's a very strong soul and he does make his presence known. And he still is trying to work on things for his family. That's just the way I feel with him. He's still talking about this needs to be wood or around that. And he's asking about glue. So.
Very particular about his
yeah.
woodworking.
Yes. It wouldn't surprise me if like, one day you get home and be like, is that glue on my paper? So that's like how he is, okay? So just know that he does leave signs.
Do it, Daddy.
Yes. I'm just still seeing him. He is fading from here, but I still see him with his arms crossed, still talking about glue. But he'll probably be with me for a while. I'm seeing a deal room right now, so just try to stay with me of how I'm seeing things. I hear a heartbeat. There's a female trying to come forward. She looks pretty young. I'm going to say probably between maybe 15 to 17, around that. I see a lot of dim room around her, and she's holding a beautiful candle, and the candle's got a glow to her. She's looking at it and she blows the candle out and she smiles. So I don't know if someone did it in memory of. I'm not really sure, but I do see a candle with her. I hear like a high ringing in my ears with her. She talks about how her head hurt pretty bad. And it's actually made it to where her jaw actually hurt just a little bit and her teeth. But she's okay. She doesn't feel that anymore. I feel that, I don't know if this was like some type of sickness that she had. She talks about even though that she was sick, she still did for others. She watched her family, she watched her mom, and it meant a lot to her. So I think the way she was raised, it showed off on her. She liked to do for others. Very godly girl. She liked to help others even though that she was sickly is what she's saying. She tried to never let it show. She tried to stay strong. She tried to leave a good memory. She knew in her heart that she was going to pass away. But she didn't want to show that she hurt or show that because she didn't want that to hurt for her mother, her family. Her mom watched her, and so she always tried to be strong. When she laughs, it makes her nose kind of scrunch up just a little bit, and she's still that way when I see her. I don't know if someone changed their hair, but she is talking about that or something with hair. I do get like an N initial with this female that is trying to come through.
Could be Natalie.
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 Okay, Natalie.
Nat.
She says that her hair is a little darker now, so I don't know what that is with her. But she is talking about hair. I don't know if someone changed their hair or if she changed her hair. I'm not really.
I changed mine. After she died, she wouldn't let me cut it.
Oh, okay. Okay, so see that right there. It's like personal. She knows. She knows. Okay, so see stuff like that. I love when they're able to talk about like something she did. She knows. It's just a sign that says I know what's going on still, and it's something personal that you would know about. As she's walking, I'm trying to see what she's trying to show me. She was in this really dim room at first, but she was holding a candle. So I don't know if someone like maybe lit a candle for her or something with the candle, but this is how I was seeing her for just a minute. She's walking into another room, and I can see a lady laying there, and she's going to her to reach for her. So I'm trying to see what she's trying to show me. She greeted this lady, so know that there is this lady. I feel that this lady grieved for her, very, very close, and she grieved daily for her. And she tried not to express it because she tried to stay strong, but she grieved so much for her. I feel that when she, and it's important for her family to know that when she took her last breath, and she closed her eyes, she knew. And when she closed her eyes and opened her eyes, Ian was reaching for her. So just know that that's how I'm seeing it. There around Christmas time, I can see a lot of like Christmas and stuff. So I don't know if she enjoyed Christmas. But I feel that there's something that she said, not only is you can enjoy Christmas, but you can celebrate. So I don't know if there's something with a birthday celebration in Christmas or December or around that with this other female. If you find out, you'll have to definitely let me know. But there's something with Christmas or
that
something.
That's just their big holiday.
That was their big holiday. Awesome. But this is what I see around them. There's a lot of Christmas tree and ornaments and such like that. I'm not getting everything down. She's taking me somewhere. I'm going to call her in if that's okay with you. She's talking about a notebook with her name scribbled all over it. So I don't know if someone has one of her notebooks, but it's got her name all in it. And she's bringing that up. She is showing me something. She's outside right now. She says this is very important. So I don't know exactly what this means, but I'm going to tell you exactly what I see. Even if it doesn't make sense, just try to remember of how I see them. I can see some trees. I can see a water stream. It's a lot of water. It's not just a little bit. It's a lot because I can hear a heavy flow. She points to this water. I would say it kind of looks, no, it's taller than this. Kind of looks like a tube, like a laboratory, it's something with this lab. I'm going to call it like a laboratory tube. I don't know the name of it, okay? And she says, it needs test. So I don't know exactly what this means. There's something with a lot of water. I don't feel it's your water, okay? But there's something with water. And I don't know exactly what she's talking about, but maybe y'all can get to the bottom of it. But there's something, she says, it's not just a little bit of water. It's a lot of water. And it needs to be tested. Okay, so I don't know exactly what that means. Maybe that'll come about. I'm not really, really sure. But she shows me like a laboratory and then the laboratory thing. So I don't know if someone wondered something or I'm not really sure. But she's just bringing that up. she enjoyed the memories of being able to lay in the bed and talk. Like, I feel like everybody piled up in the bed and they talk. And that's something that she's going to cherish always. They bring their good memories with them to heaven. And that's one of the memories that she's always going to cherish, is the piling up in the bed and talking and acting like everything's okay. People didn't really talk about, like, that I was dying. They talked about me being here now, you know. And so she is thankful for that. Something with her teeth or her jaw with her head. I'm not really, really sure, but she's just bringing that up. I don't know if maybe that hurt her. I'm not really sure, but she's just bringing that up. But just know that it doesn't hurt anymore. She is completely healed and she is okay. I'm so sorry. She's very happy for her family. And she wants them to continue to live and laugh and enjoy each other and hold hands through it. And she's okay. Just remember that she reached for this female and that they're together. She's still bringing up something with her handwriting with the notebook. So I don't know if someone's going to find something of hers with that. And it might be something to where you're going to find it and be like, oh my goodness. You know. So if you find that, it's going to have her handwriting all over it. Like that. Oh, okay. Did you read it?
Yeah, but if
it was yeah, I just play it with you. She just is mentioning that it had her handwriting in it and stuff, so she's okay, she's happy, and she is with this other female. No more pain. She takes the candle and blows it out, and she fades away. But just be, I don't know exactly what she's showing me with the water and stuff. Maybe she'll show me more. I'm not really sure. You know, I don't know if something maybe caused something for her hands to hurt. I don't know. Maybe she'll show me more with the test tube and such with the water. But no, she's okay and she's happy. Can everybody still hear me? Okay. I have to get up for just a second. There is this male trying to come forward, but he's showing, can you hold out your hands if you don't mind? Which one is it? He holds on to one of these, so I don't know exactly what this is, but he is trying to show me this arm. Okay. He just has to feel it. Okay. Sorry, I don't mean to freak you out. Okay. He had to feel it in person, kind of like, if that makes sense. Real quick, he is talking about a cut off. Where'd it go? There it is. Can everybody hear me? What in the world is this? Can everybody hear me okay? Sorry, I didn't mean to make you cry. He just needed to feel it for just a second. He's talking about a cut-off shirt that he has. It still smells like him, so I don't know if there is a cut-off shirt. No arms. He says it's got his scent on it, and he's wanting to bring that up for just a minute. Okay. Oh my gosh, what is this? He wants me to come with him for just a minute. So I try to envision of how I see him for just a second. He's taking me into this vision. I can see a porch. There is this male with him. He's trying for me to focus on this other male that's with him. So if you have to close your eyes, if you have to, just try to envision the good of how I feel him. He sits into a chair. There's two of them. He is on the left side of this other male. There's this big old bucket in front of this other male, and it looks like, I'm gonna see what it is. He's picking it up and he's rubbing it. So I'm trying to see what is in front of him, but just know I'm gonna call him D if that's okay. It's to the left of him. They're throwing pecans. I call them pecans, at each other. So I feel that there's pecans or pecans, I call them pecans, in this bucket, okay? And it's in front of this other guy. So I don't know if this guy cracked pecans. I'm not really sure. But there's something with pecans with this guy. I get an L-E. L-L-E. Okay, so this could be half of a name, part of a name, but there is this male that sits on a porch, and I do get an initial of an L or an L-E, so it's going to be around that. Now, this can be a third-party message with him, but just know that there is this male that's there with an initial L. It shows some kind of days off, and he says that he dazed off a lot, and it's like he couldn't think. Like, he could see people, but he's like, my mind just was scattered, and he needs his family to know that I heard them talking to him. So I think that in the end, when he passed away, people were still talking to him, and he needs them to know that he heard them. His mind's better now, and he needs his family to know that. But it's important to know that he heard them talking to him when he passed away. So that's a sign to say that they can still hear you. So if one of your loved ones does pass away, you can still tell them that you love them, that they hear you. He takes something out of his pocket. Okay, I can't draw, okay? But there's something that he can just be bringing this up. Now, I can still feel D, but this guy's trying to show me something that's L. I'm going to call him L if that's okay. It's got triangles on each side of it. So I don't know. It's like something like this, if that makes sense. It could be something of his. It's kind of shiny, he says. So I don't know if he has something like a little award of something or something of his. But it's got like a triangles on all corners that he's bringing up. So I don't know if he has something that represents that. I'm not really sure. Y'all may find something going through his things and you go, oh, that's what he was talking about. They show me the weirdest things, but just know that that's what I'm seeing with him at this moment. He says, come on. And so he's showing me something else. I can hear his heartbeat. And he was talking about he didn't want to be a burden on anyone. He says that he actually, like, people had to take care of him, he said, and he felt bad for that, and he tried to help, he said, because I'm a very independent man, and he liked to take care of himself, and in the end, others had to take care of him, and he says, that's just not who I am, and he's healed, and he's able to take care of himself now. He is walking, so I don't know if in the end he did not have the strength to walk, but just know that he is completely healed, and he is walking. He's walking down these steps right now, and I can see trees, and he's bringing me to that. I can see a clothesline in between two trees right now. There is two females there, and they're chattering to each other. The image is starting to change. I can still see D. He's there. But I'm seeing a kitchen table, and there's two females. One's standing, and she's holding a white cup. There's this male staring at her, and he's smiling. I get an M-A-R, so this could be half of a name, part of a name, but I do get something with an M-A-R, and the guy says, I'm Frank. I'm Frank, and he just smiles. So I feel that this could be a connection to him, this could be a third party message coming in, or this could be the connection to an L, but just know that that's what I'm seeing, okay? The M-A-R, I can see a kitchen setting around her, okay? So I feel that she's talking about her recipes, okay? So I don't know if someone had her recipes, but she's bringing that up. And she's like, it's very important. Like, you know, she's talking about these recipes, so she's going to bring that up. But I see a kitchen setting around her, so I feel that that was maybe one of her passions. All of this stuff's coming to me at one time. I'm trying to, so I can tell you what I'm seeing. D is talking about the words left unspoken. So I don't know if someone felt that they felt like they needed to talk to him or felt like the regret of not saying something. And he's saying that. He said, please don't feel that way. Please. And he's talking about the words left unspoken. I don't know what this is. He wants you to move on. He wants you to be happy, but they have to grill. They have to know how to grill. So I don't know exactly what that is. But he is bringing that up real quick.
That's my husband, David.
I hear his heartbeat. So I don't know if this is something upper with him, I'm not really sure, but he is talking, like I can just feel his heartbeat, and his heartbeat's really, really strong. He is okay. I don't know if he battled depression, but I do see a light around him, which tells me that he's in heaven and he's okay. He's really sorry. He moves things around. He says he tries to help, but he thinks that he actually makes it worse.
Yes.
Yeah. And one time a phone charger. He's mentioned that something with the phone charger.
We played grandbaby. We're moving our stuff.
It's him. This is a sign to say that I'm still there. You can still talk to him, and you do. You talk to him every day, and he hears you. It's okay. He's talking about something about getting rid of his stuff. So I don't know if you've not, and you battle that, and actually people has told you it's okay to, you know, it's okay. And he says that he wants you to know that when you're ready, it's okay. Okay? He wants you to know that it's okay. I don't know if it's something upper with him, but just know that I see the light around him and he's at peace. He does talk about the anxiety and the depression, but he needs you to know that it's not because of you. It's not because of his family, and nobody needs to blame you. You don't need to feel like it's your fault, because it's not. He loves you still. He will always. The image is starting to change. He's bringing me to the water. He needs you to go to the water. You'll relax there, and he goes there as well. I feel his energy comes and goes at the water.
He loves being in the water.
Oh, perfect. Just know that he goes there. And I think that you should go there too, because it calms your soul. He's showing me something. I can hear his heartbeat. That's why if you hear that noise, I'm going with his heart. He's showing me something. He's holding something. I hear, "You are my sunshine." And he looks down and he has a baby. He has this baby. He needs his family to know that there is a baby with him. It's very muffled sounding. When I hear them, it's like an energy of the TV, like,
"We lost a baby."
Please know that he has the baby.
Can we sing that song to all of our children?
Perfect.
As babies.
Please know that he still sings that song and he has y'all's baby. Okay? So that's just a personal thing that he's like, "It's me. It's me." And he needs you to know what he's doing and who he is. He's saying something. Tell. It's very echoey, but I'm going to tell you exactly how I hear it, okay? Even if it sounds crazy, I want you to know, I want you to experience exactly the connection of how I'm giving it to you. It's very muffled, okay? I'm going to try to make it out. Tell Cass. Jan's here. Tell Cass. So there could be a Cass around that name. A Phil that could possibly still be alive and he's maybe trying to give a third party message out.
My sister was Cassie.
Okay. Mm-hmm. There's a Jan. This could be Janie, Janice, Jan around that name.
Her aunt Janice just passed away.
Needs her to know that she's there. 50s to 60s, I would say, around that with her.
Yes.
She's happy. She needs her family to not grieve for her, but to, you know, remember her and smile, especially during Christmas time. She's there. There's a female coming up. I can still see Ale. I'm going to call him that, okay? If that's okay with you. There's two females, actually. And Dee is handing one a rose. So I don't know if there's something with Rose. Maybe a name, a part of a name, nickname. And this could also be a connection to the Ale. Or this could be a connection to Dee. I'm not really sure. But I feel that this is strongly something maybe with a part of the name that's there as well. And again, this could be a connection to the ale, but there is a female there, and there's something with maybe a rose. Maybe her name was Rose, or part of her name was Rose. He's mentioning something about someone following in his footsteps. He's bringing that up. Very proud of his children. Very, very proud of his children, okay? W's here. It's right here. W's here. Here an E is here. The image is starting to change. It comes at me really, really fast, so I'm trying to slow it down so you can see what I'm seeing. There's this male with him. This male looks between 20 and 30s, okay? So this could be a muffle, you know, it's very muffled, it's very echoed, but this could also be a third party connection, but he is there as well. I think the main thing is to let you know that he's still, and he, when someone passes away, it doesn't just end, okay? They're in heaven, and they're still going on. There's people around them. They're able to see their past loved ones and stuff, so just know that just because that they pass away, that doesn't mean that it stops there. They're laughing, so just know that he is happy. He's throwing pumpkins at this guy. There's an R-O-B, but he's throwing a pumpkin at him, so there's something with the pumpkin.
His best friend Rob was killed in a wreck.
They're throwing pumpkins at each other. Maybe there's something.
He was killed. Halloween.
Okay. See how they give me signs like that? Okay. They're laughing and they're together. R is showing me, R-O-B is showing me a number 3. This could be years past, siblings, children, I'm not really sure. Dates.
I have 3 children.
Perfect, okay. A butterfly is coming up close, okay. So he's getting a butterfly, he's twirling it around his hands, he's laughing the R-O-B. He's trying not to be too girly with this butterfly. he says number 7. So I feel that he's mentioning something for the month of July. Maybe this is someone's celebration for something, a birthday that he's trying to bring up. I'm not really sure. But he is bringing up the month of...
His baby's due in July.
Perfect. That's just a sign to say that I know, okay? He says butterflies. He's okay. He wanted to touch your bracelet, okay? And that's the reason why he sent me to you. And he's okay. Like I said, I feel his heartbeat. He wants you to move on. It's okay. You don't have to feel, don't compare him to him because he's better. But. He wants you to be happy. It's not fair for you to be alone for the rest of your life. So don't feel bad. Your friends are your family also. And he knows that. And he's thankful and he thanks every one of them who was there for you. But he says that he has to grill good. So I don't know what that is. He's starting to fade. But know that he's happy. This could be a third-party message. I'm not really sure, but I'm going to go ahead and say it, if that's okay. And if you know who this belongs to, great. And if not, maybe you can find out who this belongs to. But I know it's got to be a connection just to one of you. There is this male trying to come through, and he is throwing pumpkin seeds everywhere. So I am just waiting for the connection. Something ed or around that. So I feel that there's something with an ed. He's showing me a bench and he is sitting on this bench. I see a lot of woods around this bench that he is sitting on. He's kind of leaning back a little bit with his legs in front of him. He takes these pumpkin seeds and he throws it in front of him and these red birds come out and take the pumpkin seeds. So I feel that one of his signs is birds, particularly red birds because that's what I'm seeing around him. So he will send red birds. I don't know if there's something for the month of October, but he's bringing that up and he's making a big deal about it. And that's when he sends the red birds. very strong soul. He didn't want to be a burden on anyone. He liked to do everything himself, he said. There's this male that's trying to come forward, and it kind of shakes the bench that he's sitting on, and it kind of looks over at him. And this guy laughs and pats his back and salutes at him. So this male that's sitting beside him on this bench, they're together. They're talking. It's very muffled sounding. It's very echoed, but I'm going to try to make out and eavesdrop what they're saying. I don't know why I see the initial P. I'm not really sure, but I'm going to call him Ed. I don't know why I'm going to call him Ed for some reason, but I do see an initial P. He is laughing, but he says something along, and this could be just a sign, but he says that his name is on his love or something around that, so I don't know if his love has his name or where is his name. I'm not really sure, but he's like bragging about it to him, and he's bringing that up. They do stuff like that in heaven even to this day. And I think it's just like a sign to say that he knows. He has shown me two white doves, and they're flying around each other. And I feel that this is a type of celebration that he's trying to bring up. I feel that there was a celebration, and he needs them to know that he was there for that in spirit. So I don't know if a celebration happened or some type of achievement and they feel bad because he missed it, but he needs them to know that he was there for that. He talks about how he understands and knows that sometimes his words can hurt. He's a very honest person, but it's only because he loved his family and he was very protective of his family. If you wanted honesty and bluntness, just go to him, he'd tell you. Beside him is holding something shiny. It's taking a reflection from the sunlight and it's kind of catching my eye. So I feel that this male that's near him that's saluting is holding something shiny. I don't know if this is like a star or something along that, but he's bringing that up. Ed, around that. He's mentioning something about his shirt, but it has a tree on it. So I don't know if he has a favorite shirt and it's got something with tree or something with tree. I'm not really sure. Or it's a shirt with an actual tree on it. But he's just bringing that up. Maybe someone has that of his and it's maybe something personal or maybe one of his favorite shirts, but he is bringing that up. There is another male. I'm going to say probably between like 70s to 80s. I'm going to say more of 80s. My mouth is a little dry with him, so I don't know if in the end he had trouble swallowing or something like that, but know that he's able to swallow this other male that's with him. He takes out a napkin, so I feel like this is a sign, okay, that is with him, and it's a polka dot napkin. Okay, so I don't know if he's mentioning something about dot, I don't know, or polka dot, something, but he puts it close to his heart and he puts it in a shirt pocket, okay? This male that's with him says, tell my love that a J-A-M is here. So I feel that he needs his love to know that a J-A-M is here. So this could be a nickname, part of a name, half of a name. I feel that the J-A-M's love is there as well. I feel that they passed a good while from each other, if that makes sense. I I do feel another J8, you know, so this could be half of a name, part of a name around that. They're near the water though, because I can see the water and the waves and stuff like that around this J8, you know. Showing me a number four, so I feel that this is maybe a date, you know, siblings, years past, children around that. And then he also shows me a number seven. So that could also be a date or there as well. They're coming at me fast. I'm sorry. I'm trying to handle each one. There's another male. The image is starting to change. I can still see Ed. He's there, he's happy, and he still throws pumpkin seeds. Mm-hmm. So something with pumpkins with him. I'm not really sure what that is. But he's okay, and he needs his family to know that he does come in dreams, and he's around the little ones. So know that he is doing that. But there's this male, and the image is starting to change, and so I'm trying to take form of this image real quick. There's this male that sits on a porch, and he says, "I'm Ray." Ray, this could be a third-party message. This could be half of a name, nickname around that, okay? Actually sits into a porch, waves and smiles. Hey, I'm Ray. Okay, this is what I hear with him. Gloria. She don't really go by that though. And that's what I hear. I hear Gloria. She don't really go by that though. So I don't know if he's mentioning something with a Gloria. It could be half of a name, someone's middle name, part of the, I don't know, but he is mentioning that, but then says they don't really go by that though. So I don't know exactly what he's mentioning by that, but he is saying that. Something D niece, something niece or a D niece, I'm okay. So that's what he is saying. But this is what I'm saying with him. He's on a porch, he's okay, he's happy. But he waves. He pats his chest and still says something about the month of October. So I don't know exactly what that is, but I feel he's showing love for something in October. He needs his family to know of who is around him. I don't know if this is a father figure or a grandfather figure that's next to him that salutes, but this man holds like a shiny object, kind of like a, it looks, I don't know, it's weird. Anyway, it's little and it's very shiny. It kind of looks like a star or some type of object. Like that. I don't know if he had a boat or wanted a boat, but he's showing me a boat right now. He's very proud of his family, and he needs you to know that he's okay and he is at peace. He's still shows himself in other ways of the red bird. So don't be surprised when you leave here, you may see a red bird. When they show signs like this, you have to know that red birds fly around all day long. I know that. Like, rainbows happen. But you'll know when you get that sign. You'll get the chills, okay? Like, you'll get all of it. But just know that that's what I see with him. Real quick, sorry, no, you, hey, I feel so drawn to you for some reason. I don't know why I see this with you, but there, just, yeah, anyway, it's like a little bitty baby, like, it's little, it looks like a little hard looking, you get them out of the cakes, what are they called, I don't even know. I don't know why I see that with you, I don't know. I don't know if there's someone trying to come through for you and they're talking about the
king cake.
Yes, with the baby and stuff. Yeah, I'm just saying that with you. Okay, so just know that I'm saying that with you. I feel. Mm-hmm. Yeah. you keep them, they're talking about this baby. There's a younger energy with you, stays with you.
Stop.
It was my son's favorite holiday. And we always kept the baby, it's a big deal. I got the baby, you came to the house.
He wants you to know that he's okay. Something up with him. So I feel something with this waist up with him for some reason. I know that he's okay. And he needs you to know that he didn't suffer. This is the main thing. Okay? And it happened so quickly and he wasn't scared. So he needs you to know that. It's okay to still talk about him, he says. And you do. Every time you do, it's just like, you have anxiety, he talks about, like your anxiety level is through the roof.
Mm-hmm.
He says, in 1 minute you'll be fine, and the next minute you're like, oh my God! Like, you know, and it's just because you're in anxiety. And he does come in dreams, so just know that if you dream about him, it's real, that he does try to touch you in dreams, and that you get to hug him in dreams, and just know that he does come in dreams. But he doesn't want any regrets, and no blame, okay? Something with a pumpkin as well. And when that connection back there, he was talking about the pumpkin seeds. By the way, ED is fine. But he says something about pumpkins. So I don't know if there's something with pumpkins or something, but he brings that up.
Well, his dad's birthday is on Halloween. And my daughter's birthday is in October as well.
Okay, perfect. So it's just his way of showing love to them and saying that I'm there and that I'm okay. He doesn't want his last... I feel like the best way I can describe this, if it's okay with you to talk about this, the way he looked, he doesn't want that to be burned into someone's mind, because he's okay, okay, and he's happy, he's laughing, and he's okay. Now, there is this older person with him, so I feel that there is this older person with him, but I don't feel that the older person passed first. I feel this little boy passed first and helped greet this older person, okay? So I don't know if this was like a grandfather or a figure, but just know that there is this person there with him. He's talking about an ornament, so I don't know if someone did an ornament of his or around that, but he is bringing that up. But just know that he's not alone, and he doesn't want anyone to blame anyone, and that he's okay. But something with the pumpkins and stuff like that. He's laughing. He's okay. He's not a care in the world. Now, he's going to stay this age, the age that he is. Someone wondered that. Like, I wonder if he's going to grow up in a house. They actually wondered that. And he's going to stay this age because you feel like you've missed out and you're missing out. And so he's going to wait until it's your time one day when it's God's time and God decides that. Then when you're with him one day, which he'll be the one to greet you, he'll be with you and you can have those memories with him. He's there with you all the time and he needs you to know that. He's happy though. Mm-hmm. He's okay. Thank you for giving me a chance. I just see the
Well, I knew it earlier because you were talking about, I knew what you were talking about.
Yeah. Are you the same connection with the clouds?
Yes.
This little boy that was bouncing
yes.
on clouds. Because the reason I feel that is because he,
yes,
it is, because he had so much energy, and he still does. He's bouncing off the clouds, and I think that was his way. Is he with someone with an O?
My grandfather, Ollie.
Perfect. But he passed first, I feel.
My son passed.
Yes, the little boy passed
and
first.
My grandfather
mm-hmm.
passed.
Just know that they're together, okay? Yeah, I just see the baby with you, the little baby. And who knows, you may go home and find one. And if you find one, no.
I hope it's plastic.
Know that it's him. That's hilarious. Oh, I love it. We can cry and laugh, okay? That's so funny. I just see the baby with you. So just know that the plastic baby, just know that he is okay. And he sends those, so you may find them. And then maybe don't stop the tradition. Don't stop that. And maybe from now on, you can get them little babies and save them.
I'll do.
Oh, I was sibling. Perfect. But there is another connection, charm 2-4. Now, this could be a third party message. You know, I'm not really sure. I'm going to go ahead and do it real quick, though. This lady, there is this female trying to come through, and she's showing me a number 3. This is important, she says. I am getting a stace. This could be like half of the name, part of the name. This could be a stace, stacey, around that name. This could also be a third party message as well, but I'm just gonna take, I'm just gonna say it real quick. She's showing me a number 3 on paper. This could be, you know, years past, siblings, children that she's trying to bring up. I'm not really, really sure. This is what she's showing me though. She's also bringing me a number 2. I don't know exactly what that means, but she is just holding up 2 fingers. There's my number 3 paper. She looks to be around 30s to 40s, and she needs her family to know that she did not suffer. People worried about that. They were really scared about that. They said that they didn't find her until later. I know that's very personal, but I needed to say that. So just know that she did not suffer and she is okay. She says that my family and me fought like cats and dogs, but I still loved them. So just tell me that. That also shows me that they had their problems, but they still loved each other, and that she is okay and she needs her family to know that. They worried about her and if she did suffer, and she needs them to know that she did not. I don't think that she was alone when this happened. I feel like this maybe was an accident, but she needs her family to also know that she did not suffer. I think that was the main thing with her. There is also a male trying to come forward real quick. He's got black shiny shoes. He dips it in water and writes a J and an R. So I feel that this could be a sign. This could be half of a name, part of a name, but I feel that something with a junior or around that with him. That's something with a black shiny shoe. Maybe he liked them. Maybe he was picky about his shoes. He's near the water. I feel that he enjoyed water. Maybe that was one of his passions. He says that someone carries his name, so I feel that someone maybe is named after him, but he's very proud of that. He talks about his box. It's got his box, a lot of his items in his box, a lot of his belongings in his box, and he needs him to know that. Uh, his love is with him. They hold hands. Said that they had to be without each other for over 10 years. So they're together. There is a large to medium dog around him. If this is for you, we're trying to. There's a bunch of chatter. There is a woman there, but she's talking to another lady, so I'm trying to get this connection. She's rocking into a rocking chair, and she's holding a cover over her lap, and I'm getting around 90s with her. I'm Vin. There's a V-I-N as well there. But also there is a Helen or Helene around that name as well with this connection. So I don't know if it's for you or not, but this is what I'm seeing with this connection. They're all together. I can see a Christmas setting around them, but they're okay. Something with it looks like a toolbox, I think, or something like that, but there's stuff in it. And he talks about that it's his stuff and maybe it was passed down. But he dips his shoe in it, the JR, but he is around water is what I get with him. The connection is starting to fade. But they're happy and they're all together. It's coming at me fast. Also, a Larry is mentioned. So I don't know if there is a Larry that is still alive, but there is a Larry that's being mentioned. Connection is trying to form. There is a male trying to come through real quick. He's driving. He stops. In front of him is the ocean, it looks to be. It looks like a lot of water in front of him. And he takes an S like this and he puts it on a steering wheel of a vehicle. So I feel that this is something with an S. This is a male that is trying to come through real quick. ST, this could be half of the name, part of the name. He looks to be around 60s to 70s, around that. He's actually seemed a little confused is the way I'm seeing it. My head hurt a little bit and he seemed confused. He's talking about how he didn't want to be sick again. I don't know if he was fixing to become sick again or he just went through a sickness, but he says something about how he didn't want to be sick again. He looks up and there's this female coming out of the water to reach for him. He smiles. She blows butterflies and helps leave. The butterflies lead him into the light. Female looks to be probably around like 70s to 80s and she's showing me a number 3. So this could be years past, siblings around that. Is this for anyone? I'm trying to. Is there a Steve around that? If not, I'm going to close the connection. Okay. Because we're close to running out of time, so I'm trying to go through all the souls that want to come through. And if nobody's here for it, then I don't want to. Okay. This man just seems a little confused, and it's an S initial that is trying to come forward. Okay. I'm going to close that connection off. I don't like to, but maybe he'll come through another time. Let's see if there's anyone else who want to come through. There is. There is a female trying to show me a reddish color piece of jewelry. She talks about how it was passed down or someone has it. To me, it kind of looks like a ruby. And she says, oh, it's my birthstone. So, I feel that Ruby is maybe her birthstone around that. or maybe someone has that. There's this male calling for her. She's like, oh, he still does it. So I am waiting. This male is calling for a M-E-R-T or M-Y-R-T around that. So they're together, but he's still calling for her. So it's like a mert around that. But she's saying something about this red color, like maybe ruby is her birthstone. So I feel that maybe this is something, it could, or it could be half of a name, part of a name. Okay. Or she's talking about the piece of jewelry that's hers. There's something with that color there that she's bringing up. Does that make sense?
Yeah, my mother's name is Myrtle.
Myrtle.
Stones in July.
Okay. Perfect. Okay. She is walking into this room. So it tells me that she has no struggle to walk or anything like that. She has her energy back. But she's walking into this room and she's burgundy with her. She's taking a seat. I am waiting. There is a lot of people there. There's this lady standing up. I don't know what this is. It looks like a game of some sort. I don't know. It's got a ball in it, and it's got paper stuff in it, and it's flying around. I don't know. But it's in the front, and she's talking. Maybe this is a memory of her. Maybe she enjoyed going and playing games or something like that. But this is what she's showing me. She looks to the left. There's this male there, and he spits into a cup, and he raises up and smiles. And she just kind of looks at him and goes back to looking straight. There's a female trying to come up. To her right, sits beside her. That male is still staring at her. To the right of her, there is this female. I'm going to focus on her for just a minute because he is just like, every time I look that way. So I'm going to look at this way. So this is what your mother is seeing right now. So this is just experience of what she's like. So she's going to look this way. Very petite, small lady. Excuse me, this lady says. Okay. Could you tell a Brenda? Okay. I'm Colleen, it's going to be around that, okay? Could you tell Brenda, I'm Colin, so it's going to be around that. Could be like a Colleen, around that, okay? My love greeted me, and I was away from him for a long time. So just know that she is trying to come forward, and she needs you to tell of a Brenda, around that. But this is a Colin, around it. This is a female, and she is here. It's important for you to describe the setting that she's in. There's this lady, she's talking to everybody, and there's a lot of people there. And she's got like this really big looking see-through balls. I don't know, it's got wire in it. And I don't know the name of it, but it's got paper in it and it's rolling and paper's going everywhere. And they're together. They're all in this area playing games together. I don't know if they knew each other physically in this world, but they do in heaven. And I feel like that she's just coming by. She sits down patiently on the bench and says, will you tell Brenda? I'm Colleen, that's around that. My love's with me and we've been away from each other for quite some time, okay? Feel that this male reached for Mert. Very godly man is the way I see him. Okay. Will. There is a Will there. Okay, he's in a field is how I see him. There's sunflowers all around him, so I don't know if he likes sunflowers or something with sunflowers, but he's there as well. There is a male squatted down, kind of like just squatted down, and he picks the sunflower up and he looks at it and he smiles. A-N, this could be an A-N-T around that. This could be half of a name, part of a name, but this is a male, and he says that someone carries his name Okay, so there's an 8 in there as well. So just know that this is what I'm seeing. They're all together and they're happy. And he gives sunflowers to the one who carries his name. And he's very proud for that. They're
faded. My father's name was Anton. And my brother is named after him.
Perfect.
And she had a brother named Will. And they lived on a farm.
Perfect. Perfect. See, the sayings mean everything. And I try to tell people that. Really, really pay attention to what I see around them. Because not just what they're telling me makes sense or means something, but what's around them. And that's why, and like I said, I am not downing anyone else who does what I do. I don't know how they do it. I can just only tell you how I experience it. And even if I'm looking crazy and I'm over here muffling and all that, at least you're getting the full experience of how I see them. I want you to truly envision of the things that I see around them, because everything that I see makes sense. I want you to know what they see, you know? And that's the main thing. Perfect, perfect, perfect.
P.S. My sister-in-law's name is Brenda, but I'm not
really like that. Whoa, okay, perfect. Well, there's this lady there. At this moment, I'm hearing so many things. I'm hearing the giggles of him. I'm seeing the pumpkin seeds being thrown at me. I'm seeing the man going, "Is this glue?" So I'm seeing all of that. I'm seeing, I don't know, it's like a Arlene, and needs to know that the male is with him, with her. So if someone knows of an Arlene, something, it's E-A-R something, there's a female that is trying to come through, needs them to know that there is a male there. If I didn't make a connection with you, please don't give up. Please don't. I've had so many people come to my events and then just not get anything for 4 or 5 times, and then they come and then it just nonstop. They get 20 souls come through. When is the right time? It will happen. Just please don't give up. I appreciate your support. It means the world to me. I couldn't do this without you and without God. Thank you for coming and at least giving me the chance. Share your experience and let others know about me.